You always hear the fact that all these automakers care about are crossovers, crossovers, crossovers. That's what the car buying public wants. Well, there's another section of the car buying public that just wants fuel efficiency. Hyundai knows this. That's why they've devoted an entire platform of a vehicle to that end. This is the Ioniq, and it is available as a hybrid, a plug-in hybrid, and a full-on EV. Now, right off the bat, there's nothing terribly exciting about the styling. This is basically hybrid car 101. Up front, you have a grille that is geared towards getting through the air as easily as possible. The coefficient of drag on this is only 0.24, which is better than a lot of vehicles, including one tick better than the Toyota Prius. You do have these cool driving lamps down here. Come to the side. It's wearing special Michelin Primacy tires, which are geared toward EVs and cars that want to roll down the road efficiently. This one has the optional 17-inch wheels, which are eco-geared, so it's better for airflow as well. You got a little blue drive tag here, which is Hyundai's way of showing this is fuel efficient. This blue paint actually does look fantastic, by the way. But then you come around to the back and you have the rear end kind of lifted up, and this is where you start to get into a few issues, which I'll explain more fully when we get inside the car. So under the hood of the Ioniq, you lift this up and you will find a 1.6-liter inline four-cylinder gas engine. It's good for 104 horsepower and 109 pound-feet of torque. It's paired with a 32-kilowatt electric motor, and the combined output of the system is 139 horsepower. This is backed up by a 6-speed dual-clutch gearbox, so it's not a boring CVT like you think you'll be resigned to when you drive one of these. Now, this battery pack here is a 1.6-kilowatt-hour battery pack. If you get the plug-in hybrid, it's an 8.9-kilowatt-hour battery pack, so it's more juice to allow you to go longer on pure EV power. Now, if you get the EV version, the EV only one, well, then you're running on nothing but electric power. But here, we've got some gas. Inside, if you've been in any modern Hyundai recently, this is what it looks like. It's no different in here. There's just a few touches to let you know that you are in the Ioniq. These seats, the material feels eco-friendly, but it's comfortable and it actually looks pretty good. The outlay of the dash is nice enough. The gauges are easy to read. Actually, the displays themselves, they're pretty crisp. They're really nicely done. The font's easy to read. All the menu buttons are easy enough to press and they respond quickly enough. There is a hybrid button in here like you'd find in the Sonata Hybrid that will show you your fuel economy, your energy flow, and just how you're doing when you're driving this thing. But it also can come with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. It's got Bluetooth audio. It's got all the things you'd expect to find in a car that costs, you know, in the mid-20s up to 31,000 or so, as this one is here. Another piece I like is this steering wheel. It has a flat bottom, which is kind of funny because that's more of a performance vehicle thing. But at the same time, if you're taller, it is nice because it's easier to swing it past your legs. But it looks a little out of place here, but I'm not complaining just because of that extra room. So from behind the wheel, the good thing about pretty much any modern hybrid or EV is that it just feels like a car. It's not some weird buzzy spaceshipy thing anymore. With that 6-speed dual clutch gearbox, you have a nice engaging transmission. There's not gonna be a ton of feel in the steering wheel, but Hyundai has gotten so much better at tuning their steering ever since, I'd say, the first gen Genesis sedan. They worked really hard on it and it shows. So this isn't bad, it's just light, but that's what someone who buys this car wants. They don't want heft. So it's very easy to tootle around down this little side road here in Newport Beach, California. Visibility to the front is great. This is a nice windscreen. Off to the sides, it's fine. But then when you look in your rearview mirror, I was saying there was a problem earlier, you have that bar across the back like you would in a Prius, actually. And it cuts it down. Plus, the rear glass really isn't that big. So your rearward visibility is not great. All other angles, it's fine. So just from a general comfort standpoint, I'm 6'3", I'm 215. I fit great. I don't even know if the seat's all the way back. No, I could go back farther, but I don't need to. So that means there's plenty of room for the people back there. You've got this nice sunroof to let the sun shine in, which I'm not doing today because it is too hot in California. But the rest of this is just, it's just a good car. And it's a good car that costs not an unreasonable sum of money. And it also happens to get mid-50s to high-50s in terms of fuel economy. I know some of you are saying, but on that screen, it showed you were getting 48. But that's because I drive like an idiot. So I had to work really hard to get it down to 48. If you just cruise around, you're in mid-50s. And that is, frankly, kind of amazing. So if you need a vehicle that you think is just going to be an A to B commuter and you want to save on gas, this is a really good one. Except it has tons of safety features, new for 2018. Instead of just lane departure warning, they also have lane keep assist. It has forward collision warnings. It has all of the safety features you've come to expect from these modern vehicles, and then some more. And then it has great creature comforts too. If you don't, for some reason, have navigation, with Apple CarPlay, you do have navigation. So there's something in here that almost everyone can enjoy. The only people who aren't going to be happy with this is the hardcore enthusiast, but they wouldn't be shopping in this way anyway, unless they wanted to save their money for their weekend track toy, save money for gas, save money for tires, by having one of these to get to and from work. The obvious competitor is the Prius, which I've mentioned a few times, but you can look at the Ford Fusion Energy. There's a number of plug-in vehicles out there. They're all kind of the same. The benefit here is that Hyundai has great safety tech, a great infotainment system, probably the best fuel class based on what their commercials say in the segment, and then you don't have to tell people you drive a Prius. I'm not trying to slam the Prius, it's just not for me. So there's something special about being the newer kid on a growing and crowded block. The Ioniq has that in its favor. Thank you.